have been discussing shipping, and mainly this has been focused to ocean-going shipping, but half of the problem, and maybe the most important half, lies in ports, because these are a part of the supply chain. I will go through a little bit the problem, the fuel for ports and shipping, and what is needed for the solution. What drives the change generally, not only for ports, but for shipping as well, are the policies that are instilled by the institutions, the technology available at the time, and of course the social benefits that are expected, which relate to public health, growth, environment, and of course sustainability of transport. So what is the problem, especially in ports? The problem is emissions, and we're not talking about only CO2, SOx, NOx, but and particulate matters, but we're also talking about noise emissions. So in order to comply and solve some of these problems, we need to find new ways. Why is it a problem, and particularly in ports? It is because in ports we have a lot of ships congested. We have generators that are running off their design point, which means they're not so efficient. Ports are close to larger population areas, and sometimes, like Piraeus, for example, they create a small bowl where all the emissions are gathered. And some of these emissions, as discussed earlier, are visible. So this is a big problem. What is the solution? The solution is to change some of the new greener fuels that we have discussed as well, including electricity and hydrogen, and of course use innovative technologies to fully exploit this the possibilities. And let's start from electricity, which hasn't been discussed yet. When we're talking about electricity, we're talking about two things. One is the electricity in the port, and the other is the electricity used by ships for propulsion. In terms of ports, electricity is provided onshore, called ironing, to ships that are in the port. They turn off their generators and they use the port energy supply, which may be produced from greener sources like renewables. In terms of ship propulsion, not for ocean-going vessels for the time being anyway, but for smaller vessels, for short sea routes, especially the very short routes connecting closed seas, it is a viable option. It has the problem of very high OPEX for the time, CAPEX for the time being, especially in terms of batteries, but in terms of OPEX, it is a very favorable situation. This is a problem that has to be solved. But when we're talking about electrification, we also talk about electrification for every port-related activity. Ports, especially the ones that are close to industrial or communities in general, they are small micro-networks of electricity. They may have energy from their own renewable sources. There is a two-way power, and we can use this energy, two-way energy, in order to save peaks and couple the demand used by ports with the demand used by industry and the rest of the communities. I will not discuss LNG. The only reason I'm showing this slide, it is because it is only 2 years old and it is already very outdated. We see how many more ships have used LNG. It has been discussed in detail. All ports have to do is supply the required infrastructure so that LNG is available for ships to operate. A major energy that may, for the time being, is better suited to ports is hydrogen. Hydrogen plays a key role in clean, secure, and affordable energy generation. It offers ways to decarbonize more than one sector, not only transportation. There are available technologies today. They are still a little bit premature, but there are. But it, although it can be produced in many ways, including renewables, nuclear power, natural gas as it is done right now, and coal, hydrogen in itself can enable the use of renewables in energy generation, especially in ports, and in storing energy produced by renewable energy sources. There are, of course, challenges for hydrogen. It is very costly for the time being to produce. Currently, it is being produced only mainly by methane, but, and this we call green hydrogen, but there is also blue hydrogen that is being produced by renewable energy sources that are used to store this energy in fuel cells. Many ports have opted for the installation of renewable energy sources. This is another major fuel of the future, and this is the port of Los Angeles that has installed almost 10 megawatts of solar panels throughout the port in many areas, parking lots, unused areas, and they produce almost 1/6 of the energy required from renewable energy sources, from photocells. But we need to develop appropriate energy storage systems that can use to store the energy produced by renewable energy sources. Renewable energy sources on their own are not appropriate for the time being because they produce the energy in specific times of the day and many times the time of the day that they are not needed. So we need to have an appropriate energy storage system. In terms of newer technologies, the most promising ones are carbon capture and storage. It has been discussed earlier as well. Ports are currently becoming industrial hubs in the sense that they combine infrastructure for logistics, for energy generation, and for other activities. Carbon emissions from various activities, for example, cement, steel, or blue hydrogen production, can be used to store it and use it in order to make negative the footprint of the port, not only carbon neutral, but also negative, especially in combination with bioenergy. Also, ports can assist in collecting CO2 from various industrial sources and shipping it using ships to various other destinations where it can be eventually stored or used for the production of some of the other fuels. What all this needs is an upgrade in the port infrastructure. LNG has to be provided with specific fuel tanks. There must be fuel cells for the use of renewable energy sources. The port must provide electricity for ships because ship propulsion using electricity cannot be seen on its own, but it has to be seen combined with the electricity provision of the port. So the port has to upgrade all its infrastructure, but not only the technical one. It has to provide a more complete energy management system that measures and monitors how energy is being produced and where it is given to. And this power management system will also include the billing information and also the asset management of the port, not only for electricity, but for every other activity that takes place in a port. This can be a very complicated power management system that combines all this. Of course, there are possibilities for the use of other energy sources like LPG, as discussed earlier, or ammonia. All have problems and challenges. In the near future, I think we will see a mix of all these fuels for ports and for shipping. But eventually, we're being driven to a very clean future that is almost carbon neutral or carbon negative. And this can only be done using clean electricity or clean hydrogen, I think. But this is a little bit more long-term solution. Thank you very much.